All right, we're right back here. We're picking it up. It was the easiest thing you ever did in your life. Mind you, that was from somebody that already climbed Everest. So let's continue on
here.
This
patient is proud to be getting a medical marijuana card. Okay. At first, the woman behind the desk asks for medical records.
So if I just have casual neck pain, that's going to be okay?
In other words, you just said, is casual neck pain going to be okay? And because she didn't want to say no, because she doesn't want to say no because she's running a business, she digs a little further. And as soon as you say, hey, I've been seeing a chiropractor for a little while, well, guess what? Who just goes to a chiropractor for a little while if they're not suffering from some form of back pain or neck pain? That's why she told you that that probably would be enough, because it's up for the doctors to decide, not the girl behind the desk at the business. She's just a clerical worker.
Talk a little more, and the need for medical proof goes away.
And it's not that your medical proof went away. You still have to get the records, you dummy. She just said that seeing a chiropractor would prove that you're getting treated for pain. Bad reporting, creating a story out of nothing again.
She quotes a price cheaper than diversity.
Which still doesn't cover all of the costs.
Someone who doesn't have chronic pain or cancer. We were told.
And chronic pain or cancer? Well, those aren't the only two conditions. HIV, chronic pain, and cancer are not the only conditions. Read the law again. Read the law again. Craig read it for you before in his video.
Almost no one gets turned away.
Nobody gets turned away if they file the paperwork properly because it's a registry program. Simple. Registry program. You want a library card? Register for one. You get it. Well, medical marijuana, if you have a condition that causes severe pain, severe nausea, or any of those other conditions, and you register properly, you get it.
Again, we're going off the word of the physician.
Fergus Loughridge is the state pot czar.
The state pot czar. Once again, no, he's not. He's a guy who runs an Excel spreadsheet that can tell you whether or not somebody's an active or not an active patient in the registry.
He says state law is strict but can only go so far. There are legal loopholes, though. The state and medical boards do not routinely investigate doctors who give referrals for marijuana.
And nor should they. They can't. The Supreme Court has said that they can talk to their patients about cannabis as much as they want. They just can't aid and abet them in acquiring it. It's that simple.
The doctor's word is gold.
Physicians are bound by their creed to do the right thing.
You're right, and I took my physician's word as gold, and here's what I found out. The physicians that did nothing but give me pills almost killed me. And as soon as I found one that's got me on nothing but cannabis, boom, life is good. I'm at work. I work almost 80 hours a week, no problem, and I love every second of it because it allows me to be a productive member of society the way I was raised and always taught to grow up and become.
No one at either THC or Diversity would tell us who these doctors are. The state won't share their names.
I have no problem sharing the names of the doctors we use once you verify that you're a qualifying condition. In other words, we don't just tell people the names of the doctors. Once you show us that you're a qualifying patient, then of course I'll be more than happy to tell you the names of doctors because, well, they make their money doing what they do and we make doing what we do. We don't have any say what the doctors do. If they say you don't qualify, they don't qualify. We literally just make the appointment for you.
Marijuana card can be yours for a price. Now, our photojournalist also went to the Diversity Parlor on Maryland and did not get the same story pitched there. Despite multiple calls, no one from THC would comment about their program or their doctor, and we have set up a number of links online about the state program, what to do, what you can't do, and how you can get involved if.
Well, my hardest thing to understand is how could you post all those links that show the state law program facts and then send somebody in to tell them that they have neck pain, they've been seeing a chiropractor, even if you say it's minor. That's up for the doctors to decide, not a cashier register clerk or a clerical worker at THC. Well, I wanted to go frame by frame. Once again, we can't wait to see what they're doing tonight. We'll see what happens. Hopefully we can actually get a legitimate story done. All right, because I'm tired of having to take every one of these stories and pick it apart. Come with a real story. I've actually offered a real story, a bigger, deeper, that's actually an I-team story. This wasn't. All you did was just tell people how much it costs to get a card and explain to people that doctors ultimately have to sign the form, and if they sign the form, getting into the program is that much easier, because it is. What more to say? All right, everybody, enjoy the rest of your day. Tonight, I am going to have a video showing everybody what the flower room looks like on day one. We moved the mamas in there, and we're going to show you what they look like. So we'll see you again with another video. I probably will forget to bring the cord home, so I'll load the video up first thing in the morning. So we'll see you then. Everybody, have a great night. I'll be back in a few minutes to do a video to answer that question, but be on the lookout for that mom video first thing in the morning.